Look, it's books. Coons books.
This is my Coonsy collection. And you're like, that's a big collection. That's a lot of books.
I think I own like half of his book. He wrote too much. Let's get started. So my collection, basically, I've got it arranged in chronological order of when he published it, apart from some series I put together. StarQuest, his very first book. It's an ace double, because on the other side, it's The Doom of the Green Planet by Emil Pitaia. So that's cool. You can't do that anymore, because barcodes and whatnot. But StarQuest is actually a pretty decent little book, you know? And the thing that I love about Koontz is he wasn't an instant bestseller. He worked for decades before he ever had a bestseller. And so reading his early stuff, like this, it gives me a lot of hope as an author, being like, okay, you know, my first book was a sci-fi, and my first book sold a lot better than this one, so, you know, I'm gonna be better than Koontz one day. Maybe. Probably not. Fear that man. I had to just remind myself what this book was about. It's also an ace double, and this one, he was going through, like, a real spiritual crisis because his mom had just died. And so this one, it's about God and killing God. It wasn't very good, to be honest with you. I didn't enjoy it very much. The Fall of the Dream Machine, also ace doubles. I have two of them because, you know, I got a couple in a collection from eBay, and these books are so rare, I'm just like, yeah, I'll keep two. But this was a really good book. It was kind of like a dystopian sci-fi with the media gone rampant and whatnot. It was a really good book. Hell's Gate. It was pretty good. And this one, you start to see the elements of the thriller writer that will show up later. I was reading it, and there was passages and scenes in there that really reminded me of a John D. McDonald novel. And I think this is around the time period where he was getting into John D. McDonald, so I could see that influence starting to creep in, and it was interesting. Soft Come the Dragons, also an ace double. I haven't actually read this one. It's in fantastic shape, though. You know, I'd be ashamed to read it. I'm still gonna read it. I just realized that the other side of the ace double is also a Koontz book called The Dark of the Woods. Haven't read that one either. The Flesh and the Furnish. This was a fun little novel. It's like Toy Story just gone wrong. This was a fun one. Demon Seed. This is actually one of his early first book, I think, that got adapted into a movie. I did not read this edition because he rewrote it and published again in the 90s, early 90s, I believe. We'll see that later. So I haven't read this one. This was a seminal moment in his career as a sci-fi writer. Shattered. This is the first book I own of his as a thriller writer, where he reinvented himself. And I think this one was still originally published under his name. You'll note that he had a lot of pseudonyms when he decided he didn't want to be a sci-fi writer anymore because he had to reinvent himself. He was known as a sci-fi writer. But this is when we're transitioning into him as a thriller writer instead of a sci-fi writer. Prison of Ice by David Axton. See, this is still Koontz. His name is David Axton on here, though. And he republished it years later as Icebound. Same novel, I think basically he just updated the prose a little bit. I don't think he made any wholesale changes that I'm aware of. I haven't read this one, but I have read this one. Night Chills. This was a goodie. He was really starting to get into it, where he put elements of sci-fi into thriller, which is really the definition of what a Koontz book is for me. The Face of Fear. This was like a straightforward, very simplistic novel. Still fun. And it had a pretty good little twist at the end where he threw some red herrings at you. The Vision, one of his earlier books, obviously, we're still in the early stage. In his early part of his career, he was writing like 5 or 6 books a year. It's incredible. This was a very, there's not much to this novel. He did put an element of a ticking clock in here. I don't think it was all that well done. It is an alright little book. The Key to Midnight by Lee Nichols. Still a Koontz book. This is one of his pseudonyms. Lee Nichols, I think, was actually his most famous pseudonym. He published a bunch of books under that name. I haven't read the Lee Nichols version. I have read the Koontz version, so we'll talk about that one later. The Fun House. This is actually a novelization of a really, really shitty movie, and it's a really, really shitty book. Whispers. This is where he had his first real serial killer. And this is like a prototype of what was to come. This is one of his breakout books. Very good. The Voice of the Night. This one actually read more like a King book to me than a Koontz book. It's pretty good. The Mask. I've read it. I remembered it being blah, I don't remember hardly anything about this book. The House of Thunder. It's a good one. It left you going like, what? What is going on here? What is going on here? And then you figure out what's going on. Phantoms. Stephen King has It. I have The Dreamer. Dean Koontz has Phantoms. It's a monster with many forms. Twilight Eyes. Possibly Koontz's best book. This is a phenomenal read. Originally it was published, just the first half was published, and then the second part came out later, but this one, it's all combined, and it's so good. This is so good. The Door to December. Hold on a second while I remind myself what this book is about. Koontz titles, they make very little sense to me. Okay, this was pretty good. Not great, but pretty good. Strangers. This was the first book of his that he did without an outline, even though he was going off the outlines for earlier books. Great, great book. It's big, but it moves. It's a goodie. It is a goodie. Watchers. This is probably like his most famous book or one of them. You know, people consider it his real breakthrough book. And look at that author photo on the back. That's just hilarious the way he's changed in his author photos. I thought it was all right. I didn't think it was his best by any means, though. This did seem to mark the beginning of his fascination with dogs. Although in Hell's Gate, way back early in his career, he did have a dog in a very prominent role. So I was like, Koontz dog, yay. Shadow Fires. Pretty good. Lightning, one of his better ones. This is definitely one of my more favorite books. Midnight. If it wasn't for the little picture on the cover, I would not remember which one this is. It was all right. The Bad Place, one of my more favorite books of his. Really, we're entering the golden age of Koontz. See, I break Koontz down into three different ages. The early part, that's early Koontz. It's all right, nothing special. And now, really from about Twilight Eyes until a little bit later on, we're in what I consider the golden age of Koontz, where everything he wrote was just so good. And this is one of them. The Bad Place, it was a phenomenal read. The scenes that he does with a Down syndrome adult, when a child, where it was like the narrative voice was just astonishing the way that he did that. Cold Fire, it's still good. Not my favorite from the Golden Age of Koontz, but still good. Hideaway. I loved Hideaway right up until the end. I thought the end was kind of stupid. Dragon Tears. One of my favorites. I love this. I loved this book. It was really good. Little narcissistic demigod. Mr. Murder. This copy right here is my very first Koontz book. I picked Koontz up because King kept talking about Koontz. So I was like, who's this Koontz guy? It's a great book. It's a really good book. I was lucky to start with a good one. So if you want to start with Koontz, you know, follow in my footsteps. Mr. Murder is a good one. It got turned into a really cheesy but still fairly watchable two-part mini-series with one of the Baldwin brothers. And then I have the original paperback of Mr. Murder for some reason. Winter Moon, another one. Let me check what this book was about. Oh yeah, this one, it was a redone version of one of his earlier books. And what I read is that he added the front part onto this. Well, in my opinion, the front part of this really needed to be cut off and get to the action, which started midway through the book. So I have a feeling the original one was better than this. It was still all right, but really the front part just ruined all the elements of mystery midway through the book. If you had started there, it would have been just a really good, short, intense horror story. Dark Rivers of the Heart. Hold on a second while I remind myself what this book was about. I remember now. It was good. It's one of his, you know, government is evil books. The ending, Koontz endings are always happy and cheery, and this one, it really wasn't. It really set it up for a sequel. But seeing as it's been like 30 years since this book came out, he's probably not going to do one. Icebound. This was the redone version of Prison of Ice. It was good. It was an intense, little, fun book. The Key to Midnight. One of my more favorite. We're still definitely in the golden age of Koontz. It was a fun book that had you thinking. Intensity. This is definitely one of my favorite. The only thing that I don't like in this book are the moose. I think they were moose. Wasn't a fan of the moose, but it was an intense book, if you can't tell by the name. And the serial killer, he was just so gripping. And oh God, it's so good. Tick Tock. This book started out as just, you know, just a good old fashioned Koontz thriller novel. And then the end was like, what the hell? It's absurdist comedy, and it was so absurd, it was hilarious. It's a fun book. I wouldn't consider one of my favorites, but it was fun. The Eyes of Darkness. Hold on a second while I... Okay, yeah, this was a good one. For the most part, it was pretty good. Soul Survivor. It was good. We're starting to kind of get formulaic on his stuff, where they kind of start to blend together, but it's a good formula, so it's still good. False Memory. I've read this very recently, but I still need to remind myself what it was about. Oh yeah! Oh god, yeah, this one was so good. How could I just... Whew. Yeah, this one was phenomenal. It was really, really similar to Night Chills in the setup of it, because of some mind control kind of stuff going on. But it was done so well. This was a good one. Demon Seed. It's the redone version of his very early sci-fi novel. It was an alright little book. Nothing super special about it, but it was fun. You know, AI is bad. You would think Google and these people would learn not to screw with it by now, but From the Corner of His Eye. It's supposed to be like a really spiritual book. It dealt with like other dimensions and crap, and meh. We're starting to enter the third stage of Kuntz, which I call the Catholic stage, where he gets really, really religious, and it starts to seep into his work to a stronger and stronger degree, and so you'll start seeing the word grace slip in more and more. You definitely saw it in here. People moved with grace. They were full of grace. Kuntz, he loves grace. The name of his house
has built him a stunning California home. He calls Amazing Grace.
She seemed to be the embodiment of grace.
It's ridiculous. By the Light of the Moon. I haven't read this one. The Face. I haven't read this one either. The Taking. I need a dust jacket. If I find one with a dust jacket, I need to. Anyways, I did not care for this one at all. This is definitely, I mean, this is basically, it's dealing with the rapture turned into a popular novel. It was, no. Life Expectancy. This was a good one. I enjoyed this one. He did a great job with the cliffhangers. The Husband. It started out promising. I didn't like the end. Like, it started out with the premise of some random guy has his wife taken and they demand money. And then it turns out, I'm sorry if this is a spoiler, but it turns out that he wasn't such a random guy after all. It was because of his brother. And I didn't like that. I really wanted to be, it was a random guy. And he had to figure it out, and it wasn't because it was just he got chosen at random and he has to figure it out. I thought that would have been so much better if it had played out that way, and it just didn't. The Good Guy. Phenomenal book. One of the first Kuntz books that I read. I think this is actually still the only Kuntz book that I've read twice. I love the serial killer in here, or the hitman or whatever it was. The premise, the setup, the ending, everything was good. I liked this book a lot. Your Heart Belongs to Me. It had elements that I really enjoyed, but overall I didn't enjoy this book all that much. Relentless. It was actually pretty enjoyable. I haven't read it in a long time. This is one of the earliest Kuntz books I read. But it was certainly an enjoyable read. Breathless. This is a piece of shit. I do not like this book. It had a great setup and everything's getting set up to go, and then nothing happens. And it was a very religiously inspired book where it could have been a good thriller. Instead it was like, hey, grace. What the Night Knows. I haven't read this one yet. The Servants of Twilight. Pretty good little book. Religious cult. Religious people are on the wrong side this time. But it made you wonder. It did a good job of jumping between like the cultist view and them wondering what's going on, and then the normal people view. Where it's always interesting when you humanize both sides, you realize actually the horror of the situation, not the horror of who's after you. This is three complete Kuntz novels. The Servants of Twilight, Darkfall, and Phantoms. I think I've only... Darkfall? Have I ever read... Let me check and see if I've read Darkfall. I think I have. Oh yeah, I read Darkfall. It's like Gremlins Go to New York. It was fun. It was a pretty fun little book. Seize the Night. This is his first book in the Chris Snow series. Let me check. Yeah, Chris Snow. First book in the Chris Snow trilogy. The third book has never come out. It was pretty good. It reminded me a lot of Odd Thomas. This came out before Odd Thomas, though. Fear Nothing. This is the second part of the Chris Snow trilogy. Going back to, it reminds me of Odd Thomas, the character. The way he acts. not his abilities, but the way he acts, his mannerisms, his just everything about him, apart from his abilities, reminds me of Odd Thomas. Innocence. Very, very religious book, but it was also really good, because the character in here, people can't look at him without attacking him, without just being enraged, and he Kuntz teased you so far through the book trying to figure out what it was about him that so enraged people. Now the answer I didn't care for it all that much, but the way that he teased you along through it was just masterfully done. The City. This is actually the only Kuntz book that I put down. It's also an autographed Kuntz book, but I got like a third of the way into it, a quarter of the way into it, and there were other things I wanted to read. This wasn't gripping me all that much. I should probably go back and read it at some point, though, because I put it down because there was other things I wanted to read more, not because it was bad. Ashley Bell. This is also a signed copy. Signed copy. This was a really good book. I was surprised because I had it sitting on my shelf for a while because I'd gotten kind of tired of the religiosity, because there were some other books that came up between this. We'll deal with that in the Odd Thomas. And then I picked this one up just to see. It was so good. It was really good. There was very little religion, if any, in here. There was obviously some grace, but it was science, and it was a good, fun book. The Silent Corner, his newest book, until his next book is supposed to come out soon. I don't know if it's out yet. This one's also a signed book. I haven't read it yet. The Frankenstein series, the first two books, three books? I think it's the first two books. The ones that are set in New Orleans are really, really good. The ones that are set in the little town out in, I don't remember where, I didn't care for them as much. Odd Thomas. Really good. Really good. The ending actually threw me. Kuntz's endings tend to be fairly predictable because he always wants the good guy to win. This one, it was like, what? Oh, dude, come on. It touched on my heartstrings a little bit. Forever Odd was also good. Quick pace book. Brother Odd, I also enjoyed. Odd Hours, it was all right. Odd Apocalypse, I actually skipped on accident because I didn't look up the order of the series and I thought that the next book came before Odd Apocalypse. So I never actually read this one. Deeply Odd, super, super preachy. I skimmed through the last third of the book. I did not care for Saint Odd. This was the book that threw me off Kuntz for a while, where I decided I didn't want to read his new releases. A very, very religious book. Very preachy. It is a signed book. It's just, it was predictable. I just didn't care for it. A Big Little Life. This is his memoir, mostly of his dog, but also of his writing life. And I love writers' memoirs. They're just so engaging and gripping to me and inspiring. Listening to him come from dirt poor, just insanely dirt poor, to working his way up from barely selling any books. I mean, he was not selling books. I was selling more books than he was in his early days. Just to keep working and working and working and working and working. Now he's a huge bestseller, writing phenomenal books. So reading his story was really inspiring. And this is one that he did send to me, to Travis Wolf, Dean Kuntz. So thank you, Mr. Kuntz. I appreciate this. It was a very inspiring book on my journey to being an author. Then this actually isn't a Kuntz book. This is Dean Kuntz, a writer's biography by Katherine Ramsland. This is actually a fun read. It's also inspiring reading about his career once again. Shit ton of spoilers in here. Like, if you want to read this book, it's a good read. Make sure that you have read all of Kuntz before you read this, because she breaks down every damn book of his. I had to skip a lot of stuff in here. So I might go back and read it now that I've pretty much read most of Kuntz. Fun biography. A lot of psychoanalytical bullshit, but still fun. But that's my Kuntz collection, and in all honesty, people ask me, who is your favorite author? And the truth is, it's probably Kuntz. Very few of his books I would consider phenomenal. Very, very few of them. But they're all consistently good, usually very good, especially in his golden age. And you know, the way that he worked, the way that he didn't have instant success, and his perseverance, it's inspiring. It really is. So Kuntz is probably my favorite. Honestly, the only author right now where I have a consistent craving to read one of his books. He's certainly not without fault, but he's good. That's been my Koontz Collection. Hope you enjoyed it. And until next time, stay awesome.